Hey everybody, it's Invicta, and let's do some more ranked ladder matches with the Hunter deck. I will say that for the record, I have indeed played a couple of ranked games since the last time you saw me do a ranked ladder match, and that was because I was experimenting with a couple of different decks, and I didn't really want to include that in the Hunter series, but I will be showing the other decks to you in the future at some point. I don't really have a set schedule in order to do that, but either way, we are going to be going with the ranked ladder on the 3-star gold ladder. Let me make sure one second that the sounds are not too loud, and there we go. But I have changed a couple things about the Hunter deck since the last time you've seen it. At the time of this recording, I just released number 4 of the climbing of the ladder, the ranked ladder in Hearthstone, out on my channel. And of course, first and foremost, I want to thank everybody who has been watching and liking the Hearthstone content on my channel. It is very, very popular amongst my fans, and I could not be happier to provide you with more Hearthstone content in the future. So it does look like match number 1 today is going to be going up against a Rogue, and as you will see, you should notice immediately I do have some pretty interesting new additions to this deck, and I will talk about those whenever we do indeed, whenever it warrants discussion. So, but right now, what I will say is that I have a heavy emphasis on low-cost creatures, and I think this type of deck has been termed the Unleashed deck or something like that, but it does put a higher emphasis on just flooding the board and just going for all out DPS. Is basically what I call, some people call it the Unleashed deck, I call it a Blitzkrieg deck, because that's exactly what you do. You just charge your opponent and just see whose DPS is higher. So first card I'm going to do here is unload the tracking to see what we want. Not really that great of a tracking card, however I will be getting the Animal Companion just because I may get a chance to spawn someone like Huffer or maybe even Misha on turn 3. It's very, very nice indeed, or even I could coin and do it turn 2 here. So the Rogue opens up with the Leper Gnome here, and it looks like he's going to dagger up and deal 3 easy damage. And Arcane Shot comes out. It's a great card here. I don't really want to... I normally would not be wanting to use it here, but in this case where we do have the Leper Gnome, I don't want him to do any more bonus damage to that with that Leper Gnome here. And one thing that I will do, which may surprise you a little bit here, is I am going to coin and throw out the Snake Trap. Now, the Snake Trap is one of those new cards that I have added to this deck for a very, very specific reason. And hopefully, in the next couple of videos, I will get a game where everything lines up perfectly. I will say that I've not tried this deck on the ranked ladder. I have used it against other people, but I have not used it in the ranked ladder. I've only been doing unranked with it. So Animal Companion comes out here. Obviously, my opponent knows that it's not Explosive Trap because it would have triggered on that attack here. And it does look like we do get Huffer, and I am happy with that. I'm just going to go straight for the damage on the Rogue. Don't really want to throw out 4 damage onto the gnome, especially when the Rogue can just easily backstab it, and there you go, for no cost, and that would have been a waste of basically 2 cards. So he's going to combo it with Defias Ringleader here, and going to dagger up, deal 2 more damage to me, 1 with the gnome, 1 with the dagger, and that will be it. So Deadly Shot comes out. Again, not one of the cards that I'm really looking for right now. I think the best thing to do is to play the Explosive Trap. We don't really need to silence anything right now. I think the best thing we can do is trigger the Explosive Trap. Obviously, the Rogue knows that there's 2 secrets now. He has to realize that one of them is going to be Explosive Trap. He has to be very, very cautious as far as how he's going to handle this. Now he knows that it is going to be Explosive Trap. We wipe the board without really taking too much damage on our part. It did cost us 8 damage, but I still feel like we're in a pretty good spot right now. And here comes the Earthering Farseer, which is going to heal the Rogue back for 3. He's going to dagger up with a fresh dagger. He still has 4 cards left in his hand. Now, we still haven't really done much because I'm still waiting for... That is one of the cards that I have been waiting for. The Starving Buzzard comes out, and I think you can see where I'm going with this. I'm also going to use Deadly Shot. Yeah, actually, I don't want to use Deadly Shot. Let's go ahead and get a random Beast Companion out. Looks like it's going to be Leok, and Explosive Shot comes out. And that is also a new addition to this card deck, I do believe. It's been a couple days since I've actually... seen the other Hunter videos that I've done in this series. So it does look like he is going to combo off of Deadly Poison to get the Defias Ringleader out. Still a very, very good card here. And he's just going to continue to bum rush me down here, and he does trigger the Snake Trap, and now you get to see why I've been adding the Snake Trap to my collection. Here come the cards. Yes, indeed, the Snake Trap does indeed synergize with the buzzard. Even though the buzzard's going to die, it will trigger the buzzard before the buzzard dies. So now we have a pretty substantial board presence lead here. And unfortunately, I don't have really much of anything to combo off of this. And which is a little bit it's a little bit annoying, but let me see what we can do here. Ideally, I would like to have something along the lines of the like the hyena would be nice here, so I can feed them the snake carcasses. I think what we're going to do, I could use explosive shot, and that would get rid of that would pretty much clear the board on his side of things. I think I'm going to do just that. So this is going to be a little bit of a risk here, but I do want to clear the board. And obviously, I'm not going to be able to save all the snakes here, but I will be able to cash in this damage. That's going to be 8 big damage done, and I still have 3 beasts, or 4, actually technically 4 beasts, since Leok does indeed count as a beast. I've got Kill Command, I have Deadly Shot, we have plenty of removal. Here comes the Leper Gnome. Most likely, the Rogue is going to do 3 damage to me, and then that will be that. And he has to pretty much hope that I don't draw and unleash the Hounds. That's really what's going to end the game for me. If I am lucky enough to do that. But as you see here, we do have quite a bit of scary board presence, and rogues, especially during these days of the new, quote, new Hearthstone metagame, they don't really keep any AoE cards like Blade Flurry or anything like that, or Fan of Knives as well. So Timberwolf comes out, and that's an excellent card here, and what I'm going to do is I will be utilizing Timberwolf. There you see it's going to rebuff everything out there. We still have 6 mana to play with. Let me do some addition here. This is going to be 12, and the game is going to be over. We can just simply Kill Command and bum rush the rogue down. So game one will go pretty easily for the new Hunter deck, and that is going to be that. Give him the old well played. And hey, look at that. We get into Platinum after one game. So we'll do one more game here just to round out this video. But as you do see, I have changed the Hunter deck substantially. It still has emphasis on being a beast-centric deck. But now with the greater emphasis on we want to have a lot of cheap cost units, but buff the absolute heck out of them, and then it goes just pure DPS. It's just a 100% DPS race. So, and I have had very good success with this deck against all classes. I'm not saying it's unbeatable, because certainly I have lost before, but it's a very, very strong. It's a much stronger iteration of the Hunter deck than you've seen in the last couple of videos. First card here, first pull is really not all that great, to be honest with you. I even though I love the Dragonhawk, and that is an integral part of this build, I think I'm just going to go ahead and swap it, get something a little bit better, and we certainly get that with the Raptor, the Owl, and the Animal Companion. So we'll go ahead and turn off the emotes there, and we do get our Dragonhawk back, which is going to be pretty interesting. Hopefully we'll be able to have a way to buff it. We'll have to just wait and see. But again, I have been enjoying the new Hunter deck, just because it is so. If the game usually, I've yet to see. What I will say is that I have yet to see a game with this new version of the Hunter deck. And there you go. We do get Unleash the Hounds. Very, very good indeed. Let's go ahead and get the Raptor out. But what I was going to say is, with this new iteration of the Hunter deck, I have yet to see a game go past turn 8. Most of the games end with I do get good synergy with the snake trap, and I either feed them into the hyena, and then I get to unleash the hounds, I top deck it or something like that, and you can see how the damage gets out of control really, really fast. Even versus mages, it is still very, very viable, and that's what I like about this new Hunter deck that I have. Razor Fan Hunter is going to summon out a 1-1 boar. It's a very good card indeed. We could Arcane Shot here and just clear the board, and I think we're going to do just that. Again, with shamans, you have to treat them as if you were going up against a paladin. Obviously, the Arcane Shot will not be able to kill the Razorman Hunter, so we do have to sacrifice our Raptor, and I am going to indeed Arcane Shot the boar here. That still gives us enough mana to do a little bit of damage with Steady Shot. Roll it over. Again, my opponent did have to use basically 2 cards there for the price of, well, I guess two units, and we countered with the we countered by sacrificing one of our minions and one of our cards to take off 2 of his cards, technically 3 if you want to include the coin there. So Totemic Call comes out. It's going to be a Searing Totem. It's a pretty nice pull there for the Shaman. Deadly Shot comes out. Not really all that useful in this respect here. And we do get Huffer, and I love me some Huffer. Huffer is one of the best cards in the game whenever you are lucky enough to get the RNG from the Animal Companion. For those of you who don't know what the Animal Companion card is, Rexxar has a chance of summoning one of, I believe, three animals. It could be Huffer, it could be Leok, and it could be Misha, who is a 4-4 tank. And it's a very, very good card. Indeed, all of them are very, very nice. And especially with the way that this deck runs, it doesn't matter what it does. It really does not matter what minion I pull from it, because it's going to work well with my deck no matter what. Flame Tomb Totem comes out as another excellent card indeed, and that will be enough to kill Huffer, unfortunately. And that all of a sudden becomes a quite big that definitely becomes a huge target that we need to dispose of as soon as possible. And one thing that we can do here is we can silence it. Unfortunately, that does give our opponent the chance to recall it and save it, but right now that's the only thing we can do. We cannot allow the Shaman to start stacking minions next to the Flame Tongue, or God forbid even have him throw out double Flame Tongue, which is a very, very popular build right now for Shamans on the ranked ladder. It gets pretty brutal. And one thing I was alluding to earlier in this video was you have to treat Shamans like Paladins and Druids. You cannot allow them to retain their minions. If you have an option to clear the minions, in my opinion, you have to use it and get them off the board. So it does look like he's going to try to save this or possibly do an Ancestral Healing on it. And nope, he's just going to give it +2 attack. And okay. So a little bit unexpected there. And Starving Buzzard comes out. That's one of the cards we're waiting for. Still not going to be enough for me to that doesn't warrant me enough to throw it out yet, because I'm still waiting for one of the snake traps. It would be nice, even though we do have the young Dragonhawk here. It is not time yet for us to strike. And the Stranglethorn Tiger is going to make the Shaman have to think about what he's going to do now, because obviously I am going to remove the 4-4 if I get the chance to. The Shaman can't really do much. He could use Lightning Storm, but that still would not break stealth. And on top of that, he does not have enough damage. He does not have enough spell damage anyway to one-shot the Tiger. So I will get a guaranteed attack off here. The only question is, will he be throwing out a taunt, or will he just be throwing out a couple more minions? He may think that I'm possibly holding on to a multi-shot. He's not sure, and vice versa. Of course, I don't know what he's holding on to as well, but. Definitely looking for a snake trap would be very, very nice in this actually, it wouldn't be too bad to get an explosive trap either. So Totemic Call comes down. There is one of the other totems. Cleanse the sun well. So he is going to indeed throw out a sun fury or sunfire. I don't remember the name. Shattered Sun Cleric, that's what it is. So a pretty lucky draw there on the Stoneclaw Totem. However, we do have ways of getting around that. We do have a Kill Command out, and obviously that is what I'm going to use right now. So let's go ahead and Kill Command that one. Now I would use Deadly Shot here and hope that it hits the Shattered Sun Cleric. That would be ideal here. And at the very worst, it could hit one of the spell power. The basically worst case scenario is if it hits the Wrath of Air Totem. And right now, there's no real way to guarantee that it won't, but you have to take your chances sometimes. And really, all I'm going to do is just roll the dice anyway. So let's go ahead and roll the dice, and we did indeed get the Stoneclaw Totem, which is great here. I am going to take out the 3-3 with the 5-2. And he will most likely trade that useless Flame Tongue Totem for the 5-2, and that's fine. We're still doing a little okay here, but we definitely are hurting as far as the card draw is concerned, and we definitely need one of those snake traps. I do have two snake traps in this deck right now. So he does indeed throw out a taunt here, and he should be trading the 2-1 for the 5-2. Yep, there you go. And Totemic Call will get him another Stone Claw, so pretty lucky grab there. Animal Companion comes out. Not really ideal here. Again, we're just basically waiting at this point to synergize with the Buzzard. I have no way of protecting it. Let's see what we get. We do indeed get Leok here, and that's really all we can do. I could, if I wanted to, I could throw out the Dragonhawk. I could throw out the Starving Buzzard, and that may not be a bad option. However, we exhaust any chance of actually coming back in this game, because we are considerably behind right now on the card draw side of things. So I think the best thing we can do here is to force our Shaman to act first. Again, I have no real way of protecting the Starving Buzzard here, and yeah, we could probably clear the board, but the trade-off is that we would be expelling all the cards that we have in our hand versus a Shaman who has 7 cards in his hand right now, and that is not a fight you're going to win. So again, I'm just biding my time, waiting to see if we can get lucky enough to top deck the Snake Trap. That's really all that we can hope for this time. So Fire Elemental comes out, and it's going to deal a Battle Cry of 3 damage to any one of the Shaman's choosing. And it looks like he's going to Rockbiter or possibly Wind Fury. So we'll see what it is going to be. It would not surprise me to see Rockbiter. So there is the Rockbiter there, and he does throw it on the now dangerous and now dead Stoneclaw Totem. So if we don't get a Snake Trap in a hurry here, we're going to be in trouble. Multishot comes out, and that is a good draw. We definitely need to use that. Ideally, we want to hit at least the Wrath of Air Totem, and the Shield Master would be nice. It wouldn't honestly be bad if we hit anything on the board right now. Go ahead. We do indeed take out the Wrath of Air Totem, and we do take out, or we do deal a little bit of damage on the Flame Elemental. But again, I have no protection for the Buzzard, and I do have Explosive Shot. I do have Explosive Trap right now. And if we take a look at that, I have 18 cards in my deck. So we've gone 12 cards down. I have not seen any of my traps, which is a little bit unlucky. Actually, that's really unlucky right now. So Windspeaker comes out, and most likely you're going to see a Bloodlust, so that will be the end of this game. So that is the other side of the unfortunate circumstance of not having RNG on your side, unfortunately. So, and again, I do have those cards inside of my deck. It's just, what can you do if you don't get them? Well, let's go ahead and do one more here before I wrap this one up, as that was a little bit of a stupid game. I'm comfortable in saying that was a stupid game. We didn't see any of the Snake Traps. Again, I have two Snake Traps in the deck. I have one Exploding Trap, maybe two, and I have one Explosive Shot and two Multi-Shots as well. So it's a little bit unfortunate we didn't see that. It is going to be a mirror match here, Hunter on Hunter. And there's a Snake Trap. Hey, they do exist in this deck. So Young Dragonhawk comes out. Very good indeed. Don't really need Multi-Shot. I will keep tracking just in case if I do want to have a turn one, just so I can pick. And we do get a Bloodfin Raptor. So very, very good first draw here. Here comes the coin. And let us begin this one. Hopefully this game will go a little bit better than that last game with the Shaman. And look at that, another Bloodfin Raptor coming out. Very nice draw indeed. I'm going to go ahead and use my Golden Tracking. And that is the card that we are looking for. It is going to be the Starving Buzzard, which synergizes excellently with the Snake Trap. For those of you who don't know what tracking is, you basically lift up the top three of your deck to see which Hunter cards you can pull out. You get one, and then the other ones that you discard get reshuffled. So here we are. We're going to go ahead and turn over the Snake Trap. You may be asking, how come I'm not putting the Buzzard first? Well, because we want to guarantee that he's going to activate the trap card, and the only way to do that is to throw the Buzzard after the Snake Trap has been deployed. The reason why I say that's guaranteed, because Hunters do not have any way of directly dealing damage unless they equipped a weapon, and this Hunter probably does not have an Eagle Horn or anything like that. Another Snake Trap comes out, and that is pretty good luck for us indeed. Let's go ahead and throw out the targets there. We do indeed get the Buzzard out. I wouldn't mind having the Timberwolf out there as well. It does pose a little bit of a risk to throw it out there right now, because I don't have any way of protecting it. He could get a one-cost boar out. I think what I'm going to do is coin and also throw out a raptor just to make sure the Hunter does not get an easy snipe on the Timberwolf, which is very, very valuable, especially when we have the Snake Traps lined up and ready to attack next turn. So, oh, he is going to multi-shot, and that is something I was not expecting. But we are still okay. Deadly Shot comes out, and I'm just going to keep throwing out minions here, as we are. Even though we're behind, we're technically ahead right now, in my mind anyway. And he did have to use a multi-shot very, very early on. It's a turn 4 multi-shot, and that is a good place to put your opponent in. So turn five definitely opens up some options for the Hunter. You can start throwing out more traps. You can use Explosive Shot if you need to. He is going to play his own Starving Buzzard here and summon an Animal Companion, and it is going to be Leok. So that is going to be that. We get a Kill Command here, and Kill Command is very good indeed. I think what I'm going to do is I definitely would rather clear the board here, so let's go ahead and Kill Command Leok and take out his Buzzard as well. And as you see here, we are now technically ahead because I do have a trap card out. We still maintain our pace as far as the card draw is concerned, and we are now tied on the hit point front. So feeling pretty good about this spot. He is going to use the tracking. Not a bad choice here. And let's see what he throws out. He could throw out a Rhino. He could throw out two Raptors. He's going to throw out a Razorfang Hunter. And do a steady shot. So we're just back and forth trading right now. And this is a little bit of an unorthodox Hunter game here. Again, I wasn't expecting to see the multi-shot there, but we'll have to wait and see what this guy is going to do. So another kill command comes out, and I hate using two kill commands here. I really, really do. I think that honestly the best thing to do right now, I don't have any minions to throw out there, and I want to make sure he doesn't have any beast to buff. So let's go ahead and clear the board again. And technically we are now behind now. So he throws out another Razorfang Hunter. So this nerd had two of them there, and he is going to use steady shot. I don't know if he's thinking Snake Trap or Explosive Shot. Explosive Shot does not activate off of the Steady Shot, by the way. So we do have one of the Unleash the Hounds, and that is going to be very, very nice. And what I'm going to do is I have to use another kill command, unfortunately, but at least I'll get a steady shot out of it. I'm purposely not playing the Dragonhawk for a very, very good reason. It's because I want to throw out the Dragonhawk when I can guarantee that I can get it two attacks with it. And the only way for me to do that is if I have a minion that activates the Snake Trap, and then I use Unleash the Hounds. He knows now that it is not indeed Explosive Shot. So that tells him that it is now safe for him to throw out as many minions as he wants to. So here comes the Tundra Rhino, and that will also have charge. And he didn't attack with it for some reason. And here we go. That is the card that I don't mind seeing at all. Just any minion right now. We need him to attack one of our minions. And the worst thing he could do here, for us anyway, is to use a Deadly Shot. And that would pretty much kill the game for us as long as he does not use Deadly Shot on the Yeti. He could kill command it as well, which would be equally as bad. So let us see what comes out. And no, he's going to Hunter Mark it, and that is going to be fine with me because that is indeed going to unleash the Snake Trap, and all of a sudden we've got board presence, but unfortunately the Hunter does still have plenty of mana to deal with all that. He could use an Explosive Shot here. And no, he's going to go for a Core Hound. So he's just going to try to do the same thing that I was going to do to him, which is just bum rush me down. And if I don't do something quickly, if I can't end the game here, the game is pretty much over. And Stranglethorn Tiger comes out. That's a good card here. I think we have enough. We do have enough mana to, let's see, this would be 5, 6, 7, 8. We would have enough mana. I don't know if we have enough damage, though. So this would be 2. Let's see here. This is, that'll be 2, 4, 6. This would be 9 damage here. This one will get plus 2 damage, so that's 9, 16, and then this one will get 6. So that's 22 damage. We can actually end the game here, as crazy as this sounds, unless my math has mistaken me, which is a good chance that's possible. Let's go ahead and throw out the Timberwolf. Let's get the Dragonhawk as well. And we can unleash the Hounds, and let's see. I think I may have miscalculated. 7, 10... 19, that's a no, we can actually kill it. Are we going to be able to? Let's see, 12. So, no, we're going to be one hit point short. And that is why you want to do math, kids. That is why you want to do... Actually, no, I take that back. We are going to be able to end it because we have the Wind Fury. There we go. So we were able to burst down 22 damage, even though we were technically behind in that game. I'm glad my math didn't fail me too much. So I'm going to wrap this one up here because this is a pretty long video, and I can smell some food cooking on the oven that I should have gotten to 5 minutes ago. Thank you very much for watching, everyone. Expect more from the new Hunter deck very, very soon. Thank you for watching and supporting all the content. Hope you're having a great day. And, of course, I will see you all next time. So long, everybody.